Hello everyone, this is Sheetal Sanghvi and I welcome you all to Sanghvi Child Care Center. So today I have with me Dr. Rishi Sanghvi. He is owner of Sanghvi Child Care Center and my husband too. And he is a very well-known pediatrician in Mumbai. So today together we are going to shed some light on a very interesting topic. The common myths that we see when we are bringing up children in our lives. So tell me, Dr. Rishi, that when parents come to meet you day in and day out, what is the first common myth that you come across?
Sure. Well, the first commonest myth that I encounter in my patients is when I start giving advice to my parents about weaning.
Okay.
And the moment I say that you can introduce banana as a weaning food, the first question that rings their mind is, but doctor, doesn't banana cause cough and cold?
Okay, so then how do you explain?
Well, my logic is pretty simple. Firstly, I tell them if bananas do cause cough and cold, then firstly, they shouldn't be available in the market.
Right.
It's purely a myth that banana causes cough and cold.
Correct.
Yes, children are allergic to certain food items, but banana is not the only food item that causes cold and cough.
Correct.
So, I mean, a child could be allergic to chikus or papayas or kiwis,
right.
But that the parent will only come to know when the child tries giving it to their 6 month or 4 month old child. So, unfortunately, most of them start with banana as the weaning food, and it's around the same time that the child experiences the first episode of cough and cold. So they interlink both of them together. And so it's a tradition which has been going on for ages.
Right.
Even the grandmothers and the great-great-grandmothers always say that don't give banana to your child. But I would like to tell all my parents over here is banana doesn't cause cough and cold. It's you who have to decide whether your child is firstly allergic to any food item, and
correct.
If he's allergic, then what food item is causing allergy. Sometimes even a pediatrician will not be able to guide you, but
correct.
The parent or especially the mother who is taking care of the entire feeding habit of the child will come to know what is causing, which food item is causing my child cough, cold or rashes or any other allergies.
Correct. Wow. So well explained. So as a mother, I have a takeaway that instead of blaming banana for cough and cold or being allergic to my child, I should identify that there might be some other food item.
Precisely.
But banana is not the only cause.
In fact, banana is a very wholesome food and it has got very good nutritive value and it has got good amount of calories. So with the fear of the banana causing cough and cold, parents avoid giving bananas to their children.
Correct. And I think banana is the only fruit which is available 365 days.
Precisely.
Especially in a country like India.
Yes.
Well, so well explained. I am sure you all have got some inputs about this fruit called banana. So this was all about bananas. Now, would you like to tell us some other myth that you come across?
Well, one more common myth that parents or normally come, or I wouldn't say a myth, that a question that most of the parents come to me with me for consulting is that, doctor, my child is so and so age, but he's just not gaining weight,
right.
Although he's eating everything.
Correct. So you mean to say they always compare the body structure?
Yes, that is what I mean. Comparison is the body structure with maybe their neighboring kiddo,
okay.
Or a kiddo who's in their family of the same age who was chubbier and quite on the heavier side.
Right.
But then they say, doctor, mere bachche ka to vajan bilkul hi nahi badh raha hai. So my funda over here is clearly very simple. If a child is active, doesn't have any other major illness,
correct.
Is doing his routine activities,
okay.
His other milestones like the gross motor milestones, the fine motor milestones, the language development has been occurring at the appropriate age, then please don't look only at the weight criteria.
Correct.
Parents, unfortunately, in India or all over the world, think that a healthy child means a child who's growing and who's gaining weight. This is not true.
Right.
This is what we have been trying, especially me in my practice, I've been telling my patients that gaining weight is not the only sign of a healthy child.
Correct. And I think once the child is on other food items, when they leave milk, along with milk, I would say, when weaning happens in typical word, I think the baby fat also starts reducing.
Precisely.
And then I think maybe the parents get tense that where is that chubby cheeks gone? Where is it disappeared?
Precisely. And what parents don't understand at this age is after 4 months or 6 months of age, the new milestones come for the child, like sitting, walking, crawling, wherein the energy is burnt up.
Correct.
So there is not much energy stored in the body as compared to when a child is a newborn baby. A newborn baby does what? Just cries, drinks milk and does susu potty. So obviously
and
he
sleeps.
Will and sleeps obviously. So obviously they are like, they would like to compare that ki mera bachcha jab janam hua tha usko aise bade bade cheeks the, abhi wo cheeks sab chale gaye. So what I want to tell my parents over here is don't try to make your child chubby. It's like the lifestyle diseases like diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol, which your child would get at 60 years of age, he or she will get at 30 to 40 years of age if we try to make your child chubby. In fact, the dictum that I follow and tell my parents over here is keep your child on the leaner side so that we don't invite these lifestyle diseases. It's better for the for them and the
family. A very good takeaway today that a chubby child is not a sign of healthy child. Similarly, a lean child is not a sign of unhealthy child. So next time when you see your neighbor's child or any relative's child, don't sit and whine about it that, oh, why my child is so thin or lean, because we have got all the logic right now. Well, you have spoken about two myths that you see in your day-to-day practice. Now, I want to ask you one question.
Sure.
So, what I have heard in my counseling practice and when, you know, my friends across, when their children are growing up, they often tell that when teething happens, jab bache ke daant aana shuru hote hain, that's the time loose motions also occur. This is something that, you know, I've been hearing so often. So what is this whole funda behind this? Can you please, it's a fact or a myth? What is it?
Well, teething, it's a huge topic wherein I would say in a week I must be getting around 5 to 7 patients. Firstly, the parents are scared or worried that my child is 6 months old, still he's not got any teeth. My child is 9 months old, he's got only 1 or 2 teeth. He's 1 year old and he's still not got teeth. मेरे बाजू वाले के बच्चे को तो इतने दांत आ गए और मेरे बच्चे को तो hardly एक या दो दांत आए. Then the second thing comes is the moment the teeth comes, the next visit comes to the pediatrician is मेरे बच्चे को जुलाब चालू हो गया है.
Right.
And they attribute teething and loose motions together.
Correct.
So the point over here I would like to say is teething normally happens around 4 to 6 months of age and this is an age where a child tries to explore things around, puts things in his mouth.
Right.
So supposing if I have kept my cloth on the table or on the ground or if I keep a pen on the ground and if the child finds it attractive and if the floor is not clean, the child will take the pen or the cloth in his mouth, so the germs go in his tummy which causes vomiting and loose motions.
Correct. Okay.
One more common thing that I normally or an explanation that I give my parents is at your age, that is whatever the parents' age must be, 30, 40, 60.
Right.
I'm sure they also get loose motions at that age.
Right.
At that age.
Correct.
So I ask them a simple question. आप अभी 45 years के हो, आपको इस उम्र में जब जुलाब होते हैं, do you get teething at that age? So the answer is over there is no, we don't get teeth at that age.
Right. Right.
So I tell them, so the answer is in front of you. Please
right.
don't blame teeth, teething causing loose motion.
Correct. Wow. So this is a beautiful insight once again, that it's not teething that causes loose motion, but it's the other factors,
yes.
which Dr. Rishi just explained. So I hope you found this topic for today insightful, and thanks Dr. Rishi for
My
explaining
pleasure.
To all the parents in a very simple and very fluid language. I'm sure each one of us have some takeaway today. Thanks a lot for giving the time, and I hope you all are gaining some benefit. Please share this video with your friends also who can benefit. We would try to come up with more such topics. If you have any suggestions, kindly put in the comments, or you can email or WhatsApp us. We will be glad to make videos on different topics. And have a nice day. Stay safe. And don't forget to subscribe our channel, Sanghvi Childcare Center.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Take care.